Alright, what's up guys? My name is Derek Cushshon, and today I started off a new project. Now, you probably already know this. I don't have any transportation. My bike broke. I don't have a car. Basically just use my longboard. But the thing is, I can only push my longboard so far, as in literally pushing myself places. So because of that, I decided, you know what? Why not put an electric motor on it so I can get some extra range, if you know what I mean. And I decided to do that. But you already know how this is. I usually like doing extreme sports and stuff like that. So I was thinking, you know what? I'm gonna make it electric. Why not make it go faster than it usually does, than an electric longboard usually would. And because of that, that's when I started this project. So, basically, in order to make it electric, I needed to strengthen the longboard deck, because the one I had really wasn't all that strong, if you know what I mean. And basically, this is what I ended up with. Because as you can see from that part, I originally started off with a longboard deck that I made with 3/4-inch thick pieces of plywood that I got from Home Depot or whatever. I literally just laminated it together with some regular wood glue. But in order to get it a little stiffer, I decided to cover the bottom part with carbon fiber. I did the same thing with the top part, and then I added some grip tape on top of it as well, so I can actually stick onto this thing. Because at first it didn't have any grip tape, which also added to the danger fact of it, because I was able to fall off at any point. Yeah. Now, I also put LEDs on the side that are going to hook up to the battery pack once I'm done making that, so that will be freaking amazing. But pretty much after I got this far, what I did is I pretty much decided, you know what? I gotta find a battery pack for this. And here's the thing about battery packs: depending on what type of battery you get, you can get high voltage, high batteries. You can get high battery sag, or you can get low battery sag. Pretty much what battery sag is when the battery just dumps out all the voltage at once, and then it causes the It causes the voltage to drop because of it, as a result of that. And that's not good if you want something that gives dependable power, dependable speed. So I decided, you know what? I need to get something with a good track record. Because pretty much everyone out there, when they're making electric longboards, they use 18650 cells. I'm not sure if you know what that is, but if you don't, there's a picture of it right there. Now those, they're not really made for this purpose, but what I did find was some, you know, I don't even remember the name of the cell because it's just a string of numbers and letters. So again, a picture of it will go right there. And pretty much these cells went in an electric bus. They powered an electric bus. And if they're able to power an electric vehicle, why not make it power a portable electric vehicle? That's pretty much what I thought. So yeah, when I got those batteries, pretty much they came in the mail. And then I just went to work making the battery pack.
Your sister's lotion.
Okay.
Have you seen it? You know what I'm talking about?
No, I haven't seen it.
Little white pump.
Okay.
That's
$4
now. It's changed.
Holy smokes! Now here's a look at my dry erase board. I kind of worked out the dimensions of the batteries or whatever. Try to find out how much space I have, how much space I need to preserve, etc., etc. That's basically what I'm working with right now, and I got 20 of these batteries. Each one can supply up to 200 amps of continuous current, which quite frankly is a lot. But yeah, I gotta find out just what to do, because I mean, I gotta find out how to fit all this plus the electronics I need to control the motors, the LED lights, the battery charging circuit, all that stuff. All right, now the good thing about this is that slamming down the battery pack won't really affect the speed as much, but it will affect the range and the acceleration and power that I gain from this thing. Well, I only need 6 of these batteries to run this electric skateboard. And I know without a doubt, I'm not gonna run this skateboard without 10 batteries. But I have 20 of them. And I wanna use all 20. But I just don't know what to do. I'm not sure. Not sure yet. Alright, so it's a couple days later. I just got paid because, see, look, that's pretty much all I got. And yeah, that's about it. And I mean, you pretty much see how much you get paid. It's not that much by any means. No matter pretty much how much you get paid, you can still afford to do this. What I'm doing right now is I'm on Amazon looking for some parts. Alright, so here's the thing. It's like 3 days later, or 2 days later, whatever the heck. I did order those packages that I had showed y'all on Amazon in my shopping cart. And they should be showing up today. So, right now, I'm kind of stumped because I don't know what to do when it comes to creating this battery pack, you know? Because I'm not sure if I should do a 10P2S... Oh, no. I'm not sure if I should do a 2P10S system or if I should run a 1P10S system or whatever, because quite frankly, if you don't know what it is, I'm gonna do a quick diagram of it right now. Alright, my package is here. I think I just heard something. Ah, yeah. Alright, so let's see what's up in here. I'm gonna try to do this with one hand so y'all can see this. I know you're not supposed to cut towards yourself, but hey, why not? All Alright. So the set, do not separate. Oh yeah, this is my mixing set for the resin. Alright. Anything else in the box? Oh yeah, I think this is my BMS or something like that. Alright, I'm gonna open this up later. You know what? I'm gonna open this up right now. This is hard to do with one hand. Ah! If not, might just... Oh no, this is the charger for my battery pack that I'm making. It should be around 42 volts, 2 amps, so should be a sufficient amount of power to charge my pack. There's the charger. Alright, this is probably the BMS. Battery management system. For those who don't know. Crap. Looks like I might have to do one of those cut screens. Okay. So now let's see what's inside of this thing. Alright. Signal wires. And this electromagnetic. Well, is that EMS proof bag? Anything else? No, it's empty. Alright, cool. Alright, so this is the battery management circuit board. It's pretty cool, pretty nifty, you know? Has all these signal wires so I can balance out the battery packs, make sure it's all balanced out, not using up too much of any one battery at once. It's good. Last, but certainly not least, it's this package. I kind of know what's inside of here, but I'm going to just let it be a surprise. All right. It is the epoxy resin for my carbon fiber. So now, I can make more carbon fiber parts. So, yeah! Oh. Alright, now I'm just using hot glue to keep these wires stable. These are the signal wires. The wires that will be sent to the BMS for, so they can be balanced and drained properly. So that's that. This first level is done, so now I gotta build up another second layer of batteries to go on top of this. But first I gotta cover up all these terminals with something non-conductive. I'm probably gonna cover up with tape or something like that. So when I put the other layer of batteries on top, they don't short out, because again, these batteries can supply up to 200 amps continuously, like with no problem. And I don't know if you know about amperage, but that's a lot of amps. That's enough amperage to melt metal. So, yeah, no one wants that. Neither do I. I don't want that. Alright, since this is DIY and not professional, I'm about to use just plain old duct tape, you know? Off-brand duct tape at that. Wait. This might actually be off-brand duct tape. I think this is actual duct tape brand duct tape. So scratch that. Crap. I should have thought of this ahead of time. I'm about to set this down or something. Oh yeah, this is duct tape brand duct tape. probably the best for the battery pack, you know? Not sure if duct tape is conductive, but hey. We'll find out today. We're gonna find that out real quick. I know real well duct tape is not heat resistant, which is kind of a necessity, this type of thing, but I don't really think I'm gonna be pushing these batteries that hard, so hopefully I don't need to get heat resistant tape. If I do, I'll just replace the tape later on eventually. So now, as you can see, covered up all the terminals with duct tape. So it is to not short with the next array of batteries I'm about to plop down right on top of this. So let's start attaching more batteries.
My heart would never be much faster. Before you came round, I was ready to slow down. Before you came round, I was heading for a small disaster. Ready to blow me down.
Alright, so I almost forgot to talk to you about this. This is a temperature sensor. I'm about to take this to that battery over there so that I can always get a temperature reading of the batteries so I can make sure that they are okay. So let's do that. Perfect. Alright guys, about 3 hours later and I am done wiring everything up. Got 2 layers of batteries on there, all 10 of them are in. Wired up the BMS right there. All the positive leads of every battery is hooked up to that. I got the 3 wires coming out, the positive, the negative, and the charging wire. And I also have this wire that hooks up to the battery display. So let's see how this works. Alright, so as you can see, the battery is currently at 89%. It's at 36.7 volts. I gotta get it up to 41 or 42% each one, but like, dang. This is about to be freaking awesome. Can't wait to get the LEDs on. That's what I'm doing next. So, let's go. Alright guys, so as you can see, I have my battery pack charging. It's currently at 37 volts. It's at 93%, steadily climbing, so yeah. Alright guys, this is another day, and as you can see, I got the BMS in. All the wires are hooked up to every positive terminal of each battery in here. There are 10 batteries in total, 2 layers. It is a 1P10S system, so that is a plus. And I also covered the battery pack with carbon fiber, which is also a plus. So now all I gotta do is put this insulation on top of here and then find a way to mount this battery pack to there. But all I gotta do is put some LEDs on this mug. But like, dang. Alright, so now here is the battery pack. It's all neat, nice, and I got the 3 outputs. Well, I wouldn't say outputs. That's the positive, that's the negative, and this is the charging wire. And this old thing are just like signal wires that go to the battery monitor on the longboard. now I just gotta find out how to freaking mount this thing. I seriously do not know how the heck I'm about to mount this board. What the heck do I do? How? Just how? And that's pretty much how I ended up with this battery pack right here. That pretty much just gets bolted on to the bottom of my longboard. Now, I'm not gonna lie. I am deathly afraid of this battery pack because the power that comes out of this is just insane. Like, just look at these electronics. Just look at them. Just look at them. These cells are huge. These batteries are huge. These aren't your average lithium polymer cells. These things, again, they can supply up to 200 amps, which is a lot of amps. That's crazy. But yeah, I also put these brackets on there so that they can mount up on the other underside of my longboard deck. It gives me a fair amount of clearance as well. And I'm not gonna lie, I'm pretty happy with this battery pack. I just gotta come up with a charging solution. I have a charger for this. I just need to find like some connectors to hook up the charger to this battery pack, if you get what I mean. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this video, for this part of the series. Just trying to get y'all caught up. Pretty much every video after this will be an actual in-depth tutorial on how to do this, because I know a lot of people will probably want to make one, and hey, why not? So that's it with this video. If you want to stay up to date with this build, subscribe, like, and comment down below if you have any questions about it, and I will be sure to get back with you with those answers. With all that being said, I will see you next time. Peace.